मॉर्निंग मैम,
टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द पोस्टनेटल एग्जामिनेशन. सो व्हाट इज दिस पोस्टनेटल एग्जामिनेशन? इज ए असेसमेंट ऑफ द मदर एंड द न्यूबॉर्न बेबी टू आइडेंटिफाई द नॉर्मल एंड एबनॉर्मल थिंग्स ड्यूरिंग द पोस्टनेटल पीरियड. सो व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ पोस्टनेटल एग्जामिनेशन?
Physical and emotional well-being of the patient to restore the health status of the mother and to prevent the infection and complications.
So, which type of postnatal examination? How many type of the postnatal examination? It is three type of the postnatal examination. One is the immediate postnatal examination that we will carried out within 24 hours after delivery, and one is the
earlier.
It will carried out
7 days.
24 hours after to 7 days. One is the remote postnatal examination.
7 days to 6 weeks.
Now we will do the postnatal examination in which we will follow the bubble key. So we will discuss it one by one. First we will do the B for breast. So we will assess the breast. We have talked the five principles, that is the preparation of the nurse, preparation of the article, preparation of the patient and unit, then step of the procedure, then termination of articles, So first is the preparation of the nurse. Nurse should be physically as well as mentally. Physically,
hair should be tidy,
nails should be cut short, dress should be neat
and clean,
shoes should be well covered, there should be no ornaments. And the mental preparation, she should have the
thought,
examination, and in that we will give the less harm to the patient and more benefit. That is the positive attitude toward the patient. So next one is the preparation of the articles. A postnatal examination tray containing following articles. One is the vital tray in which firstly we will take the vital of the patient, in which we put the thermometer and we put the stethoscope, BP up test, and the different colors, red, blue and black, that is used for the monitoring of the vitals, and one diary in which we will write the normal finding of the abnormal and normal finding of the vitals. And another tray is the perineal care tray. At that postnatal examination we will do the perineal care. So this tray containing this is the bed sheet which are used to provide the privacy of this patient. This is the normous line to clean the perineal area, and this is the bowl which contain bowel solution to clean the perineal area. This is the gauze piece which are used to know the secretion from the breast. This is the gloves which are used to prevent the cross infection. This is the chital forceps which are used to remove the perineal pad from the drum. So this is the kidney tray, it is used to collect the wet waste. This is the paper bag, it is used to collect the dry waste. This is the inch tape, it is used for measurement of the fundal height and also measure the muscles, measurement of the calf muscle to know the human sign is positive either negative. And this is the sanitizer which are used to dry, maintain the dry hand hygiene. This is the Macintosh and draw sheet. It can be used when we are doing the assess the episiotomy. So at that time we will spread the Macintosh and draw sheet to prevent the bed from soiling. And one is the bed pen which are used to, before doing the fundal examination, we will advise the patient to empty their bladder. So we will use that bed pen, and we will use one drum that is here in which we will put the perineal pad for we will apply the perineal pad after after doing the examination of the perineal. This is the screen which are used to maintain the privacy of the patient. So all these articles are needed when we are doing the postnatal examination. The postnatal examination, after that we will prepare the patient, we will educate the patient, we will explain the procedure to the patient to gain their confidence, because we will use this preparation of the patient with the help of that gathered technique. So in this we will greet the patient and ask the patient, then tell the patient and help the patient and positioning and if patient is not understand our command, then we will revise all steps and explain all the procedure again to the patient to gain their confidence. After that, preparation of the unit and client units, in that there should be adequate light, there should be a dining table in which we will assess the mother. But here we will assess the mother on a bed. We need screen and we need some assistant which will help to during the examination. After that, the step of the procedure, in that we will use this bubble heat techniques in which we will assess the, first we will assess the breast, after that uterus, then the bladder and the bowel, then lochia, episiotomy, human sign and emotional state of the mother. So we will do this examination step by step. So first we will assess the breast. The step of breast examination is three. One is the inspection. In that inspection we will see the size of the breast, shape of the breast, and the primary areola, secondary areola, the primary areola, secondary areola. We see the status of the nipple. Is it inverted or extroverted? Means depressed hai ya fir it will be extroverted, means bahar ko nikle hue hai. So that we will see here, and after that we will do the physical examination, that is the palpation. This is the inspection. We will, after that we will do the palpation. In palpation we will assess the any nodes over the chest, and we will see the engorgement of the breast. If there is engorgement of the breast, there will be a warmth, there will be a raise in the redness, raise in the temperature, and that breast will be more hard than the other breast. So after that we will see the cracked nipple and retract nipple. This is the complication of the postnatal mother, and we will see the, is there any engorgement. If engorgement will be there, there will be a chance of the mastitis at that. And secondly, we will see the axillary vein will be tenderness. So we will see the vein of the axilla, it can be tenderness, but this engorgement can occur after the 2 to 3 days after the delivery, when baby is not able to suck properly due to their inverted nipple. Either the size of the breast will be very large and the mouth of the baby is very small. If we will use wrong technique of the breastfeeding, at that time baby is not able to hold the breast and not able to suck properly. At that time there will be a chance of the engorgement. Secondly, we will do check the size of the breast. So we will put one paper here and we will measure the size metry of the breast. So in breast examination, these things will be examined while doing the postnatal examination. So breast examination is completed. Now we will do the examination of the fundus. So after the delivery, the fundus height will be remain up to the umbilicus. So slightly we will flex their legs. But before fundal examination, points should be kept in mind. There should be a, we will educate the mother to empty their bladder. If bladder will be full, distended, there will be a wrong measurement. There will, we are not measure it adequately. So first we will measure the height of the fundus. After delivery, it will come up to the umbilicus. So we will do it after 24 hours of the delivery. So we will put our palm of the hand is here, and where we will get the resistance, we will put the mark over there like that, and we will measure it from the symphysis pubis to the up to the mark. So this will be up to the umbilicus. It is 20 centimeter. If it is up to the umbilicus, it will reduce 1.5 centimeter every day. After 12 days it become a pelvic organ, then we are not palpate with the help of hand. And we will second thing is, we will see the, with the help of physical examination, we will check the frameness of the uterus. So is it hard or it is bogi uterus, or sometimes it is bogi uterus, or sometimes it is known as bulky uterus. That is the cause of the PPH. At that time, we will see that. So, we will see in that any scar, linea nigra, strigrabidum, that is present after postnatal period. So, after that, we will see the bubble. We will advise the mother, are you passing the air?
Yes.
Yeah, are you passing the flatus? If mother is saying the flatus is passed, it means our bubble is working adequately. There is no constipation. There is a history of hemorrhoid is present or not. We will ask the mother regarding the history of hemorrhoid, history of constipation, and the sound of the bubbles. After that, we will set the bladder. If bladder distended, there will be a hardness of the lower part of the uterus in pelvic above the symphysis pubis. We feel it more hard, and it will be a distension. And we will ask the history of the mother, the frequency, urgency of the uterus. Is there any burning sensation, or if she or she is passed the urine after the delivery? We can explain. We can ask this thing from the mother. Mm-hmm. After that, we will go to the downward. That is known as the next point is the lochia. Okay. So in that, we will see the we will check the brain, and we will advise the patient to check the lochia. So first, we will provide the privacy to the patient. So
spread the
bedsheet. After that, we will
give
the perineal examination, in which we will assess the status of the lochia. So the type of the lochia is, first is the lochia labra. It is remain up to 1 to 3 days. And the second one is the lochia serosa. It will remain
4 to 9 days.
Then is the lochia
alba.
It will remain
9 to 15 days.
So we will see the amount of the lochia. So skin. It will depend upon the saturation of the pad. So we will see the pad of the patient. So it is very mild, which is known as scanty. Saturation of the pad. Scanty means its diameter is 2.5 cm. It is less than blood loss will be less than 10 ml. Next is the second type is light amount of the lochia. In that there will be a saturation of the pad will be more than 10 ml. Third one is the lochia moderate. In that there will saturation of pad will be more than 10 cm and amount of blood loss will be 25 to 50 ml. Next is the heavy amount of the lochia. In that the saturation of the pad will occurs within 2 hours, and the if it is complete saturated pad, the diameter will be more than 6 inches. Firstly, the diameter that is less that is in centimeter, but here it is in inches. If the diameter of the lochia pads is more than 6 inches, it indicates the blood loss is 50 to 80 ml. It can be occurs within 15 minutes or it can be occurs within 30 minutes after the delivery. After that, we will see the episiotomy. So, in episiotomy, we will follow the score of the assess the episiotomy with the help of Rita. So, first, there will be a redness. So, we will see the redness. And after that, E for edema. There can be edema because suture is here. There will be edema. E for
Ichymosis.
And if there is a gap between the suture of the skin, that is known as ichymosis. That we will see in the postnatal assessment. After that, we will see the apply new pad. to the mother and wear their clothes. After that we will do the last assessment, that is the after delivery we will assess the human sign. We will assess it with the physical examination. During physical examination we will touch the calf muscle. If it is warm, tender, it show redness will be there, it show there will be a human sign. But it can be positive or it can be negative. We will assess it with the help of that dorsiflexion. So first we will assess which leg is prone to DVT. So we will take the instrument and we will measure the calf muscle from both legs. This is our calf muscle. We will measure it. If the means if we are when we are measuring, if it is more than 2 centimeter, any length, if it is more than 2 centimeter, that leg is affected with the DVT. So we will check the human sign with the help of this measurement. It is increased more than 2 centimeter. After that we will do the dorsiflexion. So we will hold the calf muscle with the help of one hand and we will give the pressure over the plantar. So like that, if patient is saying there will be a pain when we are doing this flexion, so that show there will be a human sign is positive. So this is about the postnatal assessment. Thank you very much.
Thank you ma'am.